Good evening, viewers, and welcome to Animal Talk. Tonight we will celebrate the veterinary profession, and tonight I should have been in the reverse position to be where you are and you where I am tonight. So I was hoping that you would have been celebrating us. Yeah. April 29th is being celebrated as World Veterinary Day, and the last Saturday in April of every year is designated as World Veterinary Day. The theme for this year is diversity, equity, and inclusion. And what a fitting theme for our theme on this program, which is the One Health solution, the One Health perspective, and it fits in very nicely in the theme that is being chosen to celebrate World Veterinary Day for 2023. I think we've gone a long way in St. Lucia as it relates to the veterinary profession, and not just the profession in the sense that what is presently available for our furry friends, our livestock industry, as it relates to the ability to diagnose and treat diseases that's affecting our animal species. Tonight we'll be a little deliberate in the sense that we'll be presenting you with a snippet of some of the advances that we've made within our space at this veterinary medical center, Animal Hospital at Beau Séjour, with our extension on Church Street in Souffre at the back of Flo. We'll give you a snippet tonight as to some of the services that is available as it relates to how much of the veterinary service that we may see through the screen on the international scene, and we may not be aware of that is available right here. Before I move on, I would want to thank some persons, good wishes, that would have made it possible for us to celebrate that day here today. I want to first thank my immediate and extended families at the team at the Veterinary Medical Center, John and Nurse Berthier, Angel, our mascot, and Puppet, our service dog, who work very diligently in welcoming patients and clients to the Veterinary Medical Center Animal Hospital at Beau Séjour. I want to thank our patients and clients for making it possible for us to be able to respond to their needs and in a manner that is timely and compassionate service, and we keep growing as we be able to access the possibilities in realizing the interventions required to address their concerns as they walk into the facility. DBS and its management team, Junior, Linda, I want to make mention of those two persons for making it possible for you to have the opportunity to view and hear the program tonight, and as it has been in previous nights over the last 3 years and counting. I want to step back a bit in time. I also the staff members at the Livestock Veterinary Services, at the Ministry of Agriculture, my extension persons within the Ministry of Agriculture during my tenure in there as Chief Veterinary Officer. They too are responsible in part for me being here tonight and being able to celebrate with you World Veterinary Day. I'm going to nibble a little into the profession itself of veterinary medicine. It's for me one of these professions that is very tasking. It's a profession that is demanding of you as an individual in that you put your life online. We give it to you all to step in there and to make it possible to assist the family members of those furry friends themselves, by extension, the wide spectrum of animals that we have to deal with, from marine to wildlife, all aspects of terrestrial life, animals that are being housed within zoos, aquariums, down to the honeybee, you name it. They all fall under the auspices of the veterinarian. And again, the issue of inclusivity will function across the spectrum of health. Those of you who would have remembered COVID and those other zoonotic diseases that is manifesting and affecting human beings, where the role of the veterinarian is very eminent as it relates to the possibilities in controlling and addressing those diseases to minimize the escalation and the effect on mankind. As it relates to our foods, your animal protein source, the veterinarian is very key, plays a very key role, making sure that the foods that are made available for consumption is safe and wholesome. Again, too, the role as minimizing the escalation of zoonotic diseases across the barrier to affect humans, that role we cannot downplay it. It's so much important and relevant as we speak. Number of zoonotic diseases now hovering, waiting to stepping and present its ugly face as possible epidemics in certain countries and the possibility of the next pandemic. As I indicated on the last program, the one that is very eminent is the bird flu, and that is one that has been looked out for. Yeah. Again, it's a profession that, like I said, is very demanding, very challenging, very rewarding in the sense that what you're able to derive from it is being able to put out your all, put out your passion in being able to, for me, resolve the issues as it relates to the health and wellness of our furry friends and all the other animal species, where you can make a difference in the manner in which they walk into your clinic and walking out very joyously, and both on their faces and that of the family members. That itself for me is it's the icing on the cake when it relates to the joy that you get, the satisfaction you get in the hard work that you put in. So I would like to encourage those young persons out there who have as part of their dream and aspiration to be veterinarians. You will encounter obstacles along the way, but please don't allow that to deter you. It's challenging, yes, but very rewarding. If that is the path that you've chosen, don't let anybody decide differently for you. Yes, it's I'm hoping as we continue our journey, those of you who are aspiring to be veterinarians or to be part, not just veterinarians, but within the scheme of the profession, that you would see the relevance of being there. It's costly, yes, but again, to the passion and determination, we'll make everything possible for you. Again, like I said, we want to run tonight to be a little deliberate, just to showcase, give you a snippet as to some of what is available at the Veterinary Medical Center as we celebrate World Veterinary Day. So it gives you a snippet as to some of the things that you may be dreaming of and not realizing that it's right here at your fingertip, accessible within your reach, and can help in making the quality of life for your friends and whatever animal species that you would probably engage in. We don't prejudice our service. It's available for all livestock species, and also too available to other veterinarians who may want to make use of our services in helping them enhance the quality of service that they too would want to or is providing to their clients at their respective practices. Junior, can you start running off some of the videos for me, please?
Introducing OncoK9, the early cancer detection test for dogs. Did you know that in the US alone, there are 6 million new cancer cases per year in dogs? Like humans, dogs have a 1 in 3 lifetime risk of cancer. And cancer is by far the most common cause of death in dogs. Among our canine companions, cancer is typically diagnosed too late when treatment options are limited and chances of a cure are low. According to the American Veterinary Medical Association, early detection and treatment are the best ways to manage cancer in pets. Cancer is frequently treatable, and early diagnosis will aid your veterinarian in delivering the best care possible. There has been no blood test to detect cancer earlier in dogs, until now. Just like humans get screened for cancer, now dogs have OncoK9, a cancer screening test developed just for them. OncoK9 can detect cancer earlier, when your dog still looks healthy, so that your veterinarian can manage it more effectively. It starts with a simple blood draw in the veterinary clinic. The blood test uses the latest DNA sequencing technology at PetDX to detect 30 different types of canine cancer. We validated OncoK9 in the largest clinical study of its kind. OncoK9 can be used as an annual screening test for dogs at higher risk of cancer. Senior dogs of all breeds are at higher risk, and so are younger dogs of certain breeds. The recommended age to start cancer screening varies by breed. Some examples of common breeds at higher risk include Golden Retrievers, Bernese Mountain Dogs, French Bulldogs, German Shepherds, and Labrador Retrievers. Examples of giant breeds include Mastiffs and Great Danes. OncoK9 can also be used as an aid in diagnosis for dogs in which cancer is suspected. A veterinarian may recommend it when a cancer site is suspected but challenging to access, or when it's possible your dog has cancer but the cancer site isn't clinically evident. Defeating cancer starts with knowing your dog has it. Ask your veterinarian about OncoK9 today. To review OncoK9 test limitations and risks, please visit oncoK9.info/limitations.
Animals are experts at hiding pain. In the wild, a sick or weak animal could easily become lunch. This evolutionary benefit does not suit our pets of today. They need our treatment when they're sick and in pain. Our pets are trying to tell us something, but it is really hard for us to get the message. Often our pets are so stoic, the doctor has trouble pinpointing the pain. Or other times, they're so nervous, even the slightest touch can cause them to overreact. You can see how hard it can be to diagnose a pet in pain. Veterinarians use vital signs such as temperature, pulse, and respiration as clues to your pet's health. Abnormal vitals can signal a patient in pain, but they're not always 100% accurate, and further testing is often necessary. With the addition of Digitherm's veterinary-specific thermal imaging, your veterinarian can gather more accurate clues to where there is disease in the body. No other diagnostic aid is completely non-invasive, uncovering a patient's physiology. By mapping out the slightest of temperature differences in a beautiful, color-coded picture, a thermal image provides a roadmap to the veterinarian, identifying areas to investigate. Thermal imaging is as easy and safe as snapping a picture. Scared or excited, painful or shy, every pet can benefit from a quicker and more accurate diagnosis.
Okay, these two videos that we've presented, it's two of the services that we provide. The Onco 9DX is a test that is very new on the market to be able to detect cancer in dogs. It has the ability to detect up to 30 different cancers that would not be able to detect it, because some of your cancers may be manifesting internally, especially your angiosarcomas, particularly in the heart. There's no way that you could see this. But any cancer that is manifesting and not yet showing signs or symptoms, the test would be able to detect. And like I said, up to 30 different cancers. And the earlier you can detect those conditions, the better the chances it gives us to respond to the issues that the animal is confronting. Yeah. This is available at the Veterinary Medical Center, just to let you know. And again, you're going to hear a lot more of this and what we do next month. The month of May is considered to be Cancer Awareness Month, and we'll be celebrating this in a big way. So just look out for the flashing colors for May as we celebrate or build up the awareness and hype for Cancer Awareness Month. The other video that was played, the thermal scanner, it's a diagnostic imaging tool that we have to allow us to basically pick up injuries that is not visible upon examination and could lead to further diagnostic tests on the animal. Very insightful, gives us quite a bit of information. And again, too, the technology that maybe you may not be aware of, just letting you know that it's available right here at the Veterinary Medical Center at Bosiju for outreach down in Beaufort, and at Soufray, sorry, on Clark Street. So it's two of the inclusions that we have, and we want to let you know of. So as we celebrate World Veterinary Day, we want you to be aware of those possibilities that exist right here in our footprint on Little St. Lucia. Can we continue, Junior?
It was more than 2 years ago that Sabrina was diagnosed with kidney failure. Traditional medicine told us there was not much hope for her, and so we brought her to Dr. Ruth Roberts of Sun Dog Cat Moon Veterinary Clinic. There, Sabrina had a stem cell replacement procedure using stem cells from her own tummy fat, processed and re-injected. And together with a healthy crockpit diet, this kitty is doing fantastic. Recently, she broke her leg where it meets the hip. We were devastated and immediately brought her back to Dr. Ruth Roberts. There, using some of her cryobanked stem cells, Dr. Roberts injected the break site. The next day, Sabrina was already doing steps, and now, just a couple of weeks later, she's running stairs and has full mobility. Thank you, Dr. Ruth Roberts, and the staff at Sun Dog Cat Moon Veterinary Clinic.
Okay, this here is, presently we're the only regenerative, certified regenerative center in the Caribbean. And by regenerative, what we mean is that we are treating medical conditions by using the animal's own tissue to regenerate damaged tissue and to be able to reestablish a sense of normalcy for the animal. In this, we're using the technology of stem cells and PRP. Those of you who may have heard of it or have not heard of it, stem cells are cells that is considered to be non-differentiated cells, in that they have the ability to grow into whichever cell that they are exposed to. Whichever medium they're exposed to, they will grow into this medium, yeah? So we have that technology available at the Veterinary Medical Center. I'm happy to let you know we have had, so far, three cases treated. We're on now preparing for our fourth, and the results of those two cases have been overwhelming. I'm hoping that it's two of one client and one of another. Somebody can call and to at least share their experience of the stem cell treatment and the significant change it has brought about in those animals' lives. The last one was a Rottweiler, 1 year and two months old, and had lots of difficulty moving, couldn't climb up steps, couldn't jump. It was very difficult for him to move around. And if he was able to climb up the step, he couldn't go down because of the amount of pain that he was incurring with his joints. And after we did the first set of treatment on that dog, it was about less than 6 weeks, couldn't believe that was the dog that we've treated, the complete transformation in that dog, yeah? We're preparing a documentary to show the before and after of those treatments. So just whet your appetite. I'm just bringing this forward to you. And we had two previous ones, and up to last week, engaging with the owner and how she was so impressed and elating that the animal keep on improving. They must be about 8 to 9 year old, and things they have not done from the time they were a puppy, now they're able to do it. The amount of flexibility that they have gotten with that intervention, it's amazing. Yeah. Within the regenerative medicine as well, we also do what we call immunotherapy, and we'll talk a little more of this as we move into next month, being cancer month. We also have a vaccine available for cancers in dogs, so we can diagnose and treat as well. So it's non-invasive. It's using, again, the cancer cells of that animal, of that particular cancer, to stabilize the cancer and prevent it from escalating, yeah? So, and we have had quite a few cases that we have treated, and successfully so. Presently, we have a treatment on, which the second application is supposed to be due next week. An animal with an osteosarcoma, we had to amputate the leg to try and save the animal, and now it is going through its the second of three treatments for the condition. So, like I said, it's happening right here, for those of you who may not know. And again, to next month, being Cancer Awareness Month, a lot more information will be put out to the fore, and a lot more engagement as far as that is concerned. Okay, Junior, roll on. Yeah, this is a video of a cat that was subjected to the use of the stem cells in addressing its issues with osteoarthritis. And there is a misconception that persons will tell you German Shepherds, they don't want them because they have, as they get older, there's that disease that would manifest and they end up putting them to sleep. Against two, that disease that is being spoken of is no other than hip dysplasia, and it's a condition that affects the hip or the articulations of that animal at the hip. And it's not just German Shepherd, it affects partly all animals, especially the larger breeds. And again too, this is a thing of the past. Lots of animals have been put to sleep because they were manifesting this condition. Now, this is, like I said, a thing of the past that can be resolved with the intervention of stem cells and PRP, plasma, protein-rich plasma. The combination of we can use to regenerate the tissue, the cartilage that has been damaged and is causing that animal pain threshold to drop so low that they're unable to walk. A lot of the functions they are unable to perform, and as a result, they end up being put to sleep. So, like I said again, this is something of the past. We can intervene and allow that animal to live a normal life as possible, enhance its quality of life, and extend that period of stay with their furry family members. Yeah? Hey, Junior. Can you allow some of the pics that we have in there on the thermal scanner? Sorry, have you? Okay. This is, like I said, can you open the line for me too as well? So we can allow for some exchange with persons on. We have a number of other, the line is open, so anybody want to call and engage, we can do so. I'm going to give you a list thing of some of the services that is available at the Veterinary Medical Center Animal Hospital. We have a fully well-equipped laboratory suite. We have the capabilities to do a range of 2,000 different tests, both in-house and we can source out to our reference labs. But we have the capabilities to do so. The thermal scanner to be able to diagnose the level of inflammation, pain, areas where you have blood supplies is lacking, or the innovation to areas. It's a lot that we can diagnose now with this thermal scanner, which was not possible in the past. That capability now exists at the Veterinary Medical Center. The regenerative center, as we said, the only of its kind in the Caribbean as we speak. The ability to help regenerate damaged tissue. We have presently, we've had 3 cases done and the results have been tremendous. And we have a 4th in the making. The use of the immunotherapy to treat cancers, we've had quite a few. We have one patient in presently undergoing its second treatment, which is applied at 1 month interval, and is doing very well with an amputation. To try and save his life though. We have also introducing the ultrasound capabilities as well as far as diagnostics is concerned. That capability now lies at our facility. So, like I said, we're celebrating in a big way World Veterinary Day. So some of those possibilities that you probably did not think exist, it is available here. We dabble into, they said, integrative medicine, and our motto, our mission is to practice today the medicine of tomorrow. Hence the reason why we dabble in making our services available, cutting edge veterinary medicine available at our facility. We don't believe that being in a third world country is a reason not to be able to provide to our clients and patients medicine, first world medicine in the first or second world country. The technology allows us to do so, and we are venturing very aggressively in making that available to our clients and patients. Like I said, we believe in one medicine, and in that we don't leave any stones unturned when it relates to the responses to the cases presented to us. We try to integrate as much as possible the different realms of medicine for the betterment of our patients. We also provide, for those of you whom may not know, acupuncture at the clinic. It's one of the realms of medicine that we dabble into, traditional Chinese medicine. And again, too, it's all about trying to get the best medical response for the medical conditions of our patients. Yeah, we also do some ozone therapy as well. Ozone is it's O3, O2, which is the normal oxygen molecule. So ozone O3 is an added atom to that molecule. So, and its use is very, very amplified. Yeah. Can be used for cancer treatment, can be used for a number of basically any condition that presents itself, there is application for ozone therapy. So it's a lot. Like I said, we will be using this as a snippet as we move on. We'll be a little more insightful as to the services that is made available at the Veterinary Medical Center. Like I said, tonight we made it a little deliberate in presenting to you as we celebrate World Veterinary Day. We also do celebrate, bring to your awareness, attention in that celebration, what is available for you, for your friends, right here on our blueprint, St. Lucia. So the line is open to anyone who wants to call in, and we can have a discuss on any one of the areas that has been presented. If you want a little more insight into it, we can do so. Or just want to be part of the celebration, share with us World Veterinary Day, feel free to do so. The line is open, feel free to call. Yeah. We've made significant progress as it relates to the availability of veterinary service on Ireland. We've made quite a bit of progress in persons responding to animal welfare needs, persons taking on their responsibility as animal owners or family members of our furry friends. We've made some significant progress, and we keep on climbing. Yeah. Good evening, caller. Hello, good evening. Hello.
Hi, good evening.
Yes, good evening. How can I help?
Good evening, Dr. Joseph.
Good evening.
I would like to take this opportunity to congratulate you on World Veterinary Day 2023. Let me also take this opportunity to give credit to the Veterinary Medical Center for providing state-of-the-art medical treatment for our furry friends. Like you would say, and I must give the clinic a wow, because it looks like animals are more fortunate in advanced treatments for cancer and other ailments that humans suffer from. It's been a while, it's been decades since cancer and other diseases have plagued the human race and the St. Lucian society. And to me, much is not being done to remedy the disease or to arrest the disease. Treatments are being done, but yet persons die and much progress is not being made with the types of cancer. But in the case of your animals, we are seeing that the treatments you are using gives the animals an opportunity to continue living. I don't know if you want to throw any light on the correlation between cancer in animals and cancer in humans and the treatments that are offered. Thank you very much. I will listen to you on the television.
Thank you, caller, for your intervention, and thank you for, at least someone is appreciative of what is being done. I know there are lot more out there. Cancer is one of those diseases that continue to present itself as a mystery disease, and that the causes of cancer is not. Well, there are a lot of theories out there as to the causes of cancer, the mechanism of action of some of those pathogens or etiologies that causes cancer. But it's a disease that keeps on keep the scientists on the feet, because it's not fully understood. Yeah. So, okay, we'll give you a little insight as to on the video as to give you a little more insightful as to the response to this cancer question, and we'll come back to it.
Now available, PureVet PRP, an all-natural advanced medical solution for pets. PRP is short for platelet-rich plasma, a popular treatment among celebrities and sports athletes. Platelets are found circulating in the blood. These platelets contain important healing properties called growth factors. Growth factors are proteins that act as signaling molecules in the body. They can signal repair cells to heal damaged areas and alleviate inflammation in painful joints. Now, this cutting-edge treatment is available and affordable for your pet. The process is simple. Your veterinarian will take a small blood sample from your pet. The blood is centrifuged using the validated Ardent Animal Health PureVet PRP process. This step concentrates the platelets and provides a purified serum of the body's healing growth factors. When administered to your pet, growth factors can assist in alleviating the symptoms your pet may be experiencing. The patient receives the treatment all in one visit, and due to harnessing the body's own healing process, There are no side effects to treatment. This treatment can be offered as an alternative to your pet's current medications and even combined with most common surgeries to speed healing. Ask your veterinarian about PureVet platelet-rich plasma today. Or, to find more information, visit www.ardentanimalhealth.com.
Okay, Colin, I snipped this one in there. Your question is, it's very, one that is very intensive. It's going to take some time. And like I said, next month is dedicated as Cancer Awareness Month. And we will be delving into that subject matter very, very in depth. But again, too, there are lots of similarities, and it's the same disease. It's just that it's manifesting different species, the human and the animal species, but they manifest in the very same way. Yeah. These pictures that are on screen there right now is some pics of patients that we've scanned with our thermal scanner, and to be able to pick up the level of inflammation on these animals that you would have not have picked up by just visualizing them with your naked eye. Yes, this scanner allows us to be able to bring out so much of those ailments. So areas of inflammation and stagnation, low blood supply, innervation being interrupted, certain parts of the animal body that we can pick up in there to help strengthen our diagnosis. And again, to the better you're able to diagnose the issues of your patients, the more accurate you're able to respond and more efficiently treat those conditions. And like I said again too, the application for us is integrative medicine. We don't strictly deal with just hardcore drugs and injections and tablets. We broaden our scope as it relates to the responses available to our clients. The regenerative medicine, the stem cells, the PRP, acupuncture, ozone therapy, the immunotherapy as well for cancer treatment. So it's very broad, and we're excited in the direction in which we're moving, because some cases where would have been served as a death sentence to some of these animals, been able to make a difference in their lives. And we're hoping that we'll continue making the differences in improving, enhancing the quality of life, expanding the period of time that they will be spending with their furry families, and making it enjoyable for both parties. Yeah. Good evening, caller. Hello, good evening. Hello, you on the line? Can go ahead.
Hi, good evening, Doc.
Yes, good evening.
I am not hearing you very well.
I'm hearing you clearly.
Okay, now I can hear you a little bit better. I wanted to call to let everyone know that my two dogs were the first two dogs that you did stem cell replacement on. And when I brought them to you,
hello? Yeah, I think there was an error in there. I shut off. sorry, by error. Caller, can you please return your call? There was a mishap from my end. Sorry about that. Hello? Hello?
Hopefully this time it stays.
Yeah.
The one of the hip dysplasia, I was saying that when I brought him that day, that morning, I was heartbroken because he could not stop shaking his back legs. He was so painful. He was literally on human painkillers at that point because he was just so painful. I was actually thinking of putting him to sleep because I don't know what else could have been done for him. He's a heavy dog, so I can't say he's running around as much, but he's not shaking anymore, and he's got that smile on his face right now, and he's eager to go for those walks. The other one looked like someone may have beaten him. His front ankles were shot. He just could not stand up on his front legs. Now he jumps up on me, something he could never do before. And let me tell you, he is so happy. That dog is just so happy. It's amazing to see. When I come home, he cries when he sees me because he wants to play. And he would never play before. He would just lay there. He literally did zoomies to me the other day. He was so happy to see me. So I need to say thank you. Because now I can see maybe 3 more years with them because they're both 9 years old now. Maybe 3, 4 years old, who knows. three or four more years with them, I don't know. But I'd be grateful for free.
Thank you, caller. Very delighted to hear, well, at least you're able to call and get the line and share your experience. And I want to step in here and first to thank you for taking in that bold step, be the guinea pig in that intervention.
I'm not hearing you very well, Dr.
I said, I want to thank you for taking that bold step, for presenting your two dogs in as the two first treatments.
I think I listened to you off air because I'm not hearing you.
Oh, I'm not sure what the problem is. Okay. Yeah, I was saying I want to thank you for taking that bold step, and being the guinea pig as it relates to the first two cases of our regenerative medicine initiative. And the responses, as the client indicated, has been overwhelming. And the initially we knew that we would be getting some level of success, but at the rate which is happening and what the animals are turning out to be when we revisit their before and after videos, it's unbelievable. Yeah. So like I said, we're putting together a documentary so we can edit. So you too will have the opportunity to witness in plain view what we're speaking of, because some boosters may not really understand what we talk about. Where you have an animal not able to even to have a sitting position or a scooping position to defecate, it would take them over half an hour to be able to defecate a fraction of the feces that they want to exit. Yeah? And that was painful for them and the owners. And now they do that with so much comfort and ease. Yeah? Being able to jump, things that they were not able to do at all before. Yeah? Couldn't jump, couldn't stand on the hind legs. Now they were doing this with ease, moving around. And you could actually see the change in the animals' demeanor, the look on the face. You know, they look so comfortable now. You could see the smile is coming out now. It's radiating off the faces. The comfort in which they have now compared to what they had previously. So I'm hoping that we can give other furry friends and the family opportunities like this to share, because I'm sure there are quite a few animals out there on a similar circumstance. And something I mentioned last week, I want to again make mention of it tonight, that will make a significant difference in the ability of persons being able to give a response to the conditions of the furry friends as a result of that initiative. And this is as of next month, within the second food week of next month, we will be launching a pet insurance scheme at the facility to our clients, to our patients. And again, too, that would help make it easier for persons to be able to respond in a very timely manner to the interventions as it relates to their furry friends. Yes, we're starting off with dogs in the first instance, and we're hoping that within quick time to incorporate cats into there as well. It looks very attractive, very affordable. I can give you an insight as we speak. It's right now it has 2 tiers. We're hoping to possibly extend it. I'm not sure, but as it is right now, we have 2 tiers, a standard and a premium. Your standard tier is $500 per annum. Your premium is $750 per annum, which is per year. So the possibilities of doing a monthly payment or doing a 1 year payment, this is now being deliberated. But again, it will give family of those furry friends the opportunity to respond, like I said, in a more timely manner and to enhance the quality of life, enhance that human animal bonding with your furry friends, with our furry friends. So this I'm very excited about. So like I said, it's moving in tandem with the services that we are providing, and gives also the furry friend family the opportunity to be able to access this through their pet insurances. Your premium gives you a coverage of up to, I think it's $9,000 annually, and I don't think you're gonna ask for anything more than this. So I think it's a pretty good plan and something that I'm very excited about, and you too should be. So it gives an opportunity to be able to give a very timely response to the medical needs of your furry friends, because there would come the instance where you have to give a response and financially not prepared for, didn't plan for, and again, too, we don't plan for accidents, it just happen. So when those instances present themselves, so at least there is a response, and one that can be done in a very timely manner, and be able to address the issues, extend the amount of time spent with your furry friend, enhance the quality of life of your furry friends. And coupled with this, we will be also rolling out our One Health Solution programs as well. So there's a lot to look forward to. And like I said, next month is Cancer Awareness Month, and we'll be dabbling into a lot that you may not be aware of. The first caller who called and asked the question and asked me to leverage the difference or similarities between animal cancer and human cancer. This will be going into very in-depth analysis and response to that caller. So please stay tuned. We'll be starting off our awareness next week with Cancer Month. So we'll be dabbling into quite a bit. I want to make a intervention here. I've been mentioned of it before, and I'm going to say it again tonight, because honestly, it's been popping up its head, its ugly face, too many times. Yesterday, beautiful Malinois cross dog was taken to the clinic. It came in because it was gasping, labored breathing, and owner in a devastating state, couldn't understand what was happening. Suspected poisoning, tried everything possible. There was some improvement, but the extent of the damage was too far gone. Animal sufficed in the wee hours of the morning. And when we revisit the history that was given, it appears to be a deliberate case of poisoning. and people, we've been losing too many animals. And again, too, it's what really hurts me is the area where it's coming from. I mean, you have a number of animals coming from that area, and we would not want to believe this is a practice that has been practiced in that demographic, because you'd expect persons living there to have a certain level of decorum, a certain level of understanding. You'd expect them to be more passionate towards the animals that would be roaming or traversing the path. Yes, and I'm going to say it out loud. It's a shame to those persons living up in Kapa State, where everybody believes that it is pristine living going on there, and this is where we're getting a lot of those cases coming from. So, those of you who are listening to this program, I know there is a very active Kapa State group on social media. I think somebody should post something in there. Honestly, it hurts, and I can't believe that persons living in what is perceived to be such a pristine prestige or pristine neighborhood engaging in such practices, yeah, setting up poisons deliberately for these animals, yes, and causing pain and suffering for members of these animals and themselves, for the lost beautiful animal to be a year plus to be lost in that manner. Yeah, I can understand if it was a disease condition and when hit by a moving vehicle, yeah, but to be poisoned, man, no, that's heartless. So it says a lot, or it tells me a lot, of the caliber of persons living in that capacity environment. It may appear to be pristine, but not as pristine as we think it is, yeah, because I can't believe persons living there engaging in such D-classy activities. Still, come on, man, you can do better than that, yeah. Again, too, I just forgot to post it in. I'll try and send it into the studio during the week to post. We have a dog at the clinic, which a neighbor brought to our attention last week. Yeah. The dog has been visiting his premises, and it's a pit bull, and I guess so. Everybody has blacklisted pit bulls to be the most dangerous dog around, which I don't subscribe to. So he came in and he was frantic, and if nobody assists, he's going to get rid of the animal. So one of our assistants, John, went across, took the animal in, and he's still at the clinic. Beautiful dog. So we're going to be posting him on DBS during the course of the week. So look out, persons within the Bushes area or proximity to the Veterinary Medical Center. If you have missed one of your dog, it's a kind of a brownish brindle pit, beautiful dog, male, average maybe a year, 6 months, if that old, with a green collar. So if you're missing your furry friend, furry family member, you can probably check us out tomorrow with proper identity, if you come in the claim. And if not, we're going to be posting it on DBS so persons can, if they view it, or can make mention to the owners, or the owner can claim. So that's where it is. Again, I would want to thank everybody, or persons who have contributed in one way or another, us being here today to celebrate World Veterinary Day, in whichever way that you have contributed, big or small, we want to thank you for doing so and continue doing so. So as we continue, we can continue celebrating that day in a bigger way. And again, too, we would like to see persons step up the game and take on their responsibility as animal owners and minimize the sufferings of these animals. And again, those persons who are deliberately making it their duty for the demise of those animals by certain poisons. Honestly, I think the police should step up the game, because this is a criminal offense, and too much of that has been happening and nothing has been done about it. Yeah, but if they see a pit bull walking down the road without a muzzle on, you want to take actions. But what is happening if those persons going out there deliberately poisoning those animals? Yeah, this is a criminal offense. I think it's time that some of those persons should be taken to task. Thank you all for viewing, and again, to we will continue celebrating, and again making it possible that we provide for you the best possible animal care right here in Sonesha at the Fetney Medical Center. Thank you and good night, and see you next week, same time, same place, at DBS, 8 o'clock, Animal Talk. Merci. Bonsoir.
Introducing ActiStem, an affordable same-day regenerative cell treatment procedure for pets. Repair cells are found circulating through the body and stored in tissues awaiting to be mobilized by result of injury or disease. Once called upon and trained by the body, these cells are responsible for healing. These repair cells we already have in our bodies are being utilized and studied across the world in human and animal medicine, offering a new cutting-edge treatment for disease. Now veterinarians have access to utilize this cutting-edge treatment strategy in their practice. As we age, our stem cells' response to injury and ability to repair can decrease or be overwhelmed due to disease. Degenerative disease, such as osteoarthritis, can overwhelm your pet's own natural repair process, leading to pain, inflammation, and limited mobility. Osteoarthritis has a long-term impact on the patient by causing loss of cartilage and accelerated lameness. ActiStem therapy provides an all-natural solution to rebuild and regenerate cartilage, as well as repair tissues and processes the way the body intended. This provides a solution to the underlying cause of the disease, as opposed to just suppressing the symptoms. A large concentration of these repair cells are stored in adipose or fat tissue. Unlike painful bone marrow procedures, fat offers a safe and easy harvest of adult regenerative cells. ActiStem therapy is a same-day procedure that allows isolation, concentration, and activation of your pet's own repair cells. To date, over 20,000 pets have been treated with ActiStem across the world. The animal is prepped for surgery, where the certified veterinarian removes 2 to 4 tablespoons of the patient's fat. This fat is processed utilizing a university-validated method and equipment designed specifically for the Ardent Animal Health ActiStem process. Once the cells are processed and concentrated, they are activated with components from the patient's blood and light, then ready to be given into areas of need. The patented activation of the cells allows for rejuvenation of the repair abilities, no matter the age of the patient. The procedure is all natural, with the cells being derived from the patient and given back to the patient. Once reintroduced, the cells can then focus in on damaged areas. The cells then start to rebuild, repair, and alleviate pain. The ActiStem therapy treatment is the only regenerative cell treatment evaluated and tested in a randomized, double-blind, placebo-controlled conducted university trial to demonstrate safety and effectiveness of ActiStem therapy for companion animal patients. Success is measured by the overall well-being and quality of life for the patient after treatment. In many cases, pain decreases and mobility increases. In one recent trial, 90% of the patients improved after ActiStem treatment as quickly as 30 days after receiving the therapy. If a retreatment is necessary in the future, cells can be cryostored for future use. The cells can be delivered by mail for reapplication at your convenience. In addition to mobility issues, regenerative cell therapies are being studied in many other patients suffering from internal medicine conditions, including atopic dermatitis, autoimmune diseases, inflammatory bowel disease, renal disease, and stomatitis, among others. ActiStem therapy is covered by most major pet insurers. When compared to long-term medications, ActiStem can provide an affordable and alternative solution to your pet's condition. Ask your veterinarian today if ActiStem therapy is right for your pet, or visit us online at www.ardentanimalhealth.com.